little ones. What was the message at halftime? You guys shoot 14 threes in the first half and then only one in the second half. Really penetrating a lot better after half.
Yeah, maybe found the creases better. I wouldn't even have known that if you hadn't said that. But a little bit more persistent maybe in trying to find creases in there and then converting and then also, get to the free throw line and then make them in that second half. So pretty determined team, figured out a way. That's so hard to play against them. And they're extremely patient. I thought we showed good patience tonight. But your instinct against the zone is to shoot threes. And, we didn't shoot it very well the first half. I thought we had great lift from Terrell, obviously, in that first half offensively. But, it becomes a formula of a team that has made some strides and is growing. Terrell has a good first half, and then we get, some other guys stepping up in the second half. I thought Antonio finished well, and obviously Flavian made some plays for us. And Marcus, as he always does, competes right till the end. So, and I thought Paul did a great job of staying in the game despite the fact he had foul trouble and showed him making those two big free throws late.
Was it the plan to box in one or zone in one Hansen from
the
get-go?
Yeah, I mean, that was the, credit to Coach Durden. I mean, he really pushed that, and there's a risk in that with ability of some of our guys to shoot it, but Hansen never got in the flow, and then when he did get an open three late, he missed it. But overall, our guys, stuck to it real well, I thought. They're not a one-headed monster by any means. We knew other guys could score for them, and they did. That score ends up about what it does with a team like Idaho State's in the 60s, in that range. And so they had other guys step up and make shots despite us taking Hansen out.
Coach, why was the offense so efficient, especially in those last several minutes of the second half?
Well, we made some shots, and that's what it has to be. We made some really nice one-on-one plays, and the shot clock's running down. We didn't panic. I think we've really started to mature. Some guys in this team aren't settling. When that clock's at 4 or 5, if you look at us a month ago or longer, we might have hucked a wild shot. Instead, we're being more patient and sharing the ball even in those moments and finding a way to do something positive with it going downhill. And we did that tonight.
And you kept some really important buckets in transition.
Yeah, I mean, that was big. And you're just against that zone, you're trying to get a bucket however you can. And obviously, transition buckets help.
And you carry that over to the next game?
Well, I mean, you got to relax, enjoy this tonight, but obviously really good team coming in Saturday night, a whole different style, a whole different pace about them, and a whole different team. So, we've got to turn the page, but it's pretty late in the league. Everybody's in the same boat knowing how hard it is. You can't relax very long.
Why do you think Antonio plays so well at crunch time?
Well, he's made some big plays tonight. I thought he did a great job. I thought he was sputtering a little bit at times and trying to get going. But he made big plays coming down the stretch. And that's, what you want to see from your seniors.
You talk about just Terrell's resilience. He hasn't played fantastic lately, but then he comes in tonight, carries the offensively and does a great job.
Well, he's strung some games together.
Yeah.
I mean, he played good in Northern Colorado, and he is a kid that just sticks with it, and every day is the same with him, and you don't get those ups and downs, and those guys always find a way eventually to make the plays for it. And Terrell, man, that was a big first half he had for us. And I thought he did a really good job of trying to, slow down one of the league's best players. Just chasing him around, that takes a lot out of a guy. So he did a really nice job.
All right.
Thanks,
Coach.